Hello, my name is Mirza Daniel, and this project has been directed by Eng Yan Wei with his close associates Muhammad Afiq, Arif Hazen, and myself included. And without any further delay, let's jump into the video. The very first electric motor was invented by Thomas Davenport in 1834, and nearly two centuries later, electric motors are almost everywhere in our daily lives and also have been implemented into a wide range of vehicles. And now we would like to present the correlation between the brushless DC electric motors and the three-phase AC electric motors.
When looking at the methods and experiments, it can be concluded that the brushless direct current motor has its own advantages as well as disadvantages. Looking at its advantages, one of them is that it does not have any carbon brushes, which reduces frequent replacement requirements of the brushes, as well as maintenance costs. It is also available in small compact sizes and provides a high torque to weight ratio. Additionally, it produces comparatively low operating noise as compared to other motors of the same power ratings. It also has a feedback control to monitor and control the speed and the torque, resulting in accurate control providing higher efficiency, low power consumption, as well as a long battery life. The permanent magnet from the motor allows for cost minimization for manufacturers. Moving on to the disadvantages of the brushless direct current motor, when it is operated at low speed, slight vibrations occur. However, the vibrations do reduce when it is operated at high speed. Due to the inherent natural vibration frequency of the brushless direct current motor, sometimes the natural frequency can match and come close to the vibration frequency of the body or plastic parts of the machinery it's in, resulting in the occurrence of resonance. And its final disadvantage is that it has less torque compared to its counterpart AC motors.
So for three-phase AC electric motor, let's go to the advantages and disadvantages of it. For the advantages of this motor, it is simple and thought as it is being extremely durable and capable of any operating in any environments. Another one is with the absence of the brushes, commutators and slip ring, their costs are much cheaper and the maintenance for this motor is free. In contrast to synchronous motor, three-phase induction motor have self-starting torque. Therefore, no starting methods are required for this motor. That is the advantages of it. Now let's go to the disadvantages of this motor. First one is poor starting torque. Another one is draw high in rush current causing large momentary voltage dip. Always operate under lagging power factor and also difficult in speed control due to advance in power electronics. Variable frequency drive. So that's it for the method experiment for brushless DC motor and three-phase AC electric motor. So for the result part of this assignment, for brushless DC motor, we could see that there is a lot of good advantages rather than the disadvantages. The good advantages is it is small, have high torque, produce low operating noise, high efficiency, low power consumption, long lasting battery, and low cost. So we could conclude that brushless DC motor is one of the best motors that have been produced out there. For three-phase AC electric motor, in terms of advantages and disadvantages, yes, the same number of advantages and disadvantages. The advantages is have a self-starting torque, low cost, free maintenance, simple and torque weight. So this motor is suitable for people who is looking for a cheap and but a powerful motor.
The goal of the experiment was to understand and compare the differences of brushless DC motor and a three-phase electric motor, whether that be their advantages or disadvantages, unique features, or their impact towards modern technology, and it is safe to say that these aspects were investigated adequately. First action was to question ourselves, what is a brushless DC motor and what is a three-phase electric motor? So, we took to many resources to gather information and brought about the common factors and features of these motors. We settled on their construction, working principle, their power consumption and noise level, as well as their cost. These became a baseline for our understanding of the individual motors. After identifying these traits, we continued with an experiment, figuring out their advantages and disadvantages of each motor and set them side by side to compare the results.
All in all, both electric motors achieve a similar goal but with a different method. Each motor has its own specialties and roles in its own field. Thus, one motor would achieve a specific criteria such as cost, and meanwhile the other would achieve noise level.